Hi folks, let's start turning on this candle. This is so important for the first experiment of today that helps us understand the project that we are going to build. I have here on the phone an app that is this one, and it's free and is used to transform the speaker into an air blower fan, so powerful that it can turn off the fire in a couple seconds. So you can see, you just have to place it precisely in front and the speaker then can push so much air that can turn off the fire in a couple seconds. So today we transform the speaker into an air blower, but for the same principle, I can modify and turn like a fan like this one into a proper speaker. Let's see how. Mouse in hand, and let's start to design and draw in 3D all the parts we need for this project. I want to take inspiration from RC helicopters, so the blade, the rotor on the top. So let's start to draw this part.
The center part will hold 5 blades, will be made with aluminium, and I also want to design the holders of the blades in metal, so this may probably will be aluminium as well. Inside I can place a screw so that the holder can swivel on itself, so I can change pitch of each blade. That's the reason why I also decide to design a little bracket. This bracket, this little arm is so important so that I can take it, pull it and change pitch of each blade. So I designed everything 5 more times and now basically we are ready. What we have to design now is just the blade. This component has to be as lighter as possible so that can respond quickly to the frequency of the subwoofer, and this basically is the design ready. That looks nice. I just want to print it.
Okay, it took me all day to design and draw everything, but I'm pretty happy on the result. I'm pretty sure it can work, and now it's just a matter of fabricating the parts. I can use a 3D printer, a filament one, so the parts are stronger, but in this case I want to have them in aluminium. So I'm going to use a 5-axis CNC machine because the shape is so complex, and I ordered them online very cheap, and so let's wait for the package arrive. Inside we have all the aluminium parts and also the plastic parts we need for this project.
And it's so incredible for me to see how identical are the parts from the 3D file to the physical object. So consider this at the beginning, all these parts at the beginning was a solid aluminium block, and a 5-axis CNC machine can machine all these weird shapes. And that's amazing, and also the surface of all the parts are incredibly smooth. So thank you so much, this is my Italian sponsor. But let's start with the first component. I will call it the pitch changer of the blades. These have to spin on top of a ball bearing. This is a very small ball bearing that uses like rollers inside, and you can see that all the parts are so precisely machined that also the ball bearings fit so smooth inside. It snaps in place, but it's also a great idea to add 2 little caps that I just 3D print with my own 3D printer so that I can hold the inner part of this ball bearing. So I can fix everything in place with 10 screws, and you can see it spins freely, but I can also add some grease. That's a great idea. Now let's take copper tube. I choose one not only because I have the same dimension of the inner diameter of the ball bearing, but also because it's made in copper, and you probably know that copper can spin much easier on stainless steel, so it has like a natural low friction point between the two materials. Later you will understand the reason why. This copper component is also used to pull back this angle, the pitch angle changer of all the project. Let's take a very heavy and solid wood base and now mount a huge motor. The huger it is, the better it is.
So this is just a regular subwoofer, it's a 500 watt one, and it's impossible for me to fabricate something like this. It's so precisely made. We have a paper cone that is perfectly centered with the magnet, and basically how a subwoofer works is very easy. The more air it can push, the much louder the bass will sound. So this is just an air movement machine. So we can replace it and fabricate myself a subwoofer using a motor. And in this case, the more power we have to the motor, the more power we have to the subwoofer. So this is a very cheap way to have very strong bass. So in this case, I can use a washing machine motor, but I have here this that is an old table saw motor, and it's a very strong motor. It's 2000 watt motor, and yeah, I can place it here and see how to continue the project. That's great.
Of course, everything has to spin. spin smoothly, so ball bearings are installed, some holders, these are 3D printed, and I have to mount like a little tripod, two little tripods, so that they can hold everything at the perfect height, perfectly centered in front of the motor. So these two little tripods are then screwed to the wood base. Having a very heavy wood base is so important because vibration will shake all the structure, so make everything very, very strong. So I install also an aluminum shaft, and you can see everything spins smoothly on these new ball bearings. You can see that now we are installing the first component we built together, the one with the copper tube. You can see now everything is smooth, but also adding some grease will help to reduce the friction between the two parts. I can then install also the holders of the blades. You can see that this has precisely machined holes, and also the center part has precisely machined holes, so precisely that also the threads are amazing. I can thread this 8mm screw, and this part can swivel without problems, and I can screw everything and install all each component in place. Remember to add like glue. This is a thread blocker. This is so important because vibration can let the screw unscrew by themselves. So I don't want to lose blade when the project is turned on, so adding this glue is crucial. To help to swivel the parts, I can then add some oil or some grease, so the movement is so smooth, and that's amazing. So I can install everything in place, and you probably now understand how the project is going. I then now to take some little brackets, these I just bend them by myself, and I can install them between the pitch changer of the blade and the blade holder itself. Right now I'm just using some regular screw, like wood screw, just for a prototype reason. Later, if everything works, I can replace the screw and make put proper bolts. But now you can imagine how everything is working. With one single stroke of the copper part, I can then change pitch of all five the blades. That's great, because the faster I can change pitch of the blade, the more power will be generated and the more heavier the bass will sound. That's amazing. It works.
Wow, I'm so happy. It's almost hypnotic to see all the parts working smoothly without problems. That's great. Are made in aluminium. This is great because later it will stand so high forces and everything has to be very strong. It will work like a fan. You know that a subwoofer works just because it pushes a very impressive amount of air, and the same principle has to have our blade. It has to change angle of attack and push much air as possible. You can see how the good 3D print quality is made. This isn't an FDM printer, it's a powder printer, and it's so lightweight I decided to make the blade lighter as possible. That's the reason why we have all this hexagonal structure, and also the material is very lightweight. This is very important because the lighter it is, the faster it will change angle and push air to create the sound. So let's cross the finger, install them, and let's hope it doesn't take off.
Lucky for us, all the parts fit perfectly. I designed precisely all the parts with the computer and also manufactured them so precisely that also all the holes align perfectly and 10 little screws can be placed inside. Now I can clearly see how huge is coming this rotor. When I was designing it at the computer, I didn't realize how big it can get. This it looked like a proper airplane fan. So let's take a solenoid to activate and change pitch of each blade automatically. I have to choose one very powerful, and I already know where to get one. This is a starter motor from a diesel car, and you can see that this little component is a proper solenoid. Basically it takes the gear that is inside and move it backward and forward. This is so important for us. It is inside like an electromagnet, so every time we give electricity to this component, it will suck back this little piston, so it's basically a piston activated by a magnetism, so with electricity. I design and cut with a laser all these wood parts that will hold the solenoid straight. Now I have to just search for a place where to mount everything, and I think I'm gonna put it here on top of the motor. There's this very flat base, and I can use some epoxy glue to glue everything. But first, before gluing the part, let me add a little bracket. This is made with stainless steel and connects the solenoid to the copper part, so the angle, the changer of the angle of attack of each blade here to the copper part. This is a very precise procedure. When the solenoid isn't activated, all the Blades are perfectly flat, and only when the piston retracts, all the blade will change pitch and start to push air. Now that we know how precisely we have to position the blade, I can then glue and let the glue cure for about 10 minutes. And now finally I will say, the mechanical part is ready, let's start to the electronic. I can use an amplifier, an audio amplifier, and a control box unit to activate the motor. The motor will spin always with the same rhythm, but the solenoid is activated by an MP3 reader. I also drill a very huge hole here in the door. This step is so important, otherwise this fan will work like a regular ambient fan, will only push air, but we want to create sound, and the solution is this, placing it between two different rooms. Probably if we have an open window, that's a great idea. But let's start the motor. The motor will spin always with the same speed. What changes is only the solenoid. Every time there is a bass, so a rhythm, the solenoid is activated by the MP3. So let's start with a very regular rhythm. I'm talking about 1 Hz, so 60 BPMs. This is a very common frequency, so we can test if everything is working and the power of it. So let's turn the motor. I don't want to push it all the way at full speed because I'm scared that probably with the centrifugal force I can make the blade explode.
Whoa! Organi dentro lo sento. Wow. Let's stop here. This is making so much noise today. The neighbor is gonna think that there's like an earthquake here and they're escaping from the house. But no, this is not an earthquake. It's just this rotary subwoofer.
And now that we know that everything works with a constant BPM, let's start to test it with some music. I don't think it would work, but let's try it out. Never mind.
That create this very, very strange sound. At the beginning when I was building this project, I thought that we'll create like a very deep bass, like at a rave party or in a disco club, and you can really feel this very deep sound with your ears, but this is different. You cannot really feel it loudly with your ear, but mostly by your body, with the whole body. So it's the pressure, it's like a pressure system here in the room. Basically, we transform the whole room, the whole space here, like a wood box of a subwoofer. So you can imagine the sensation that I'm feeling right now is like being a little insect inside the wood box of a subwoofer, and the subwoofer is changing the pressure inside the wood box, and I'm the little insect feeling and being surrounded by all these changes, and so strange, such a weird sensation, really. I consider that this subwoofer, this rotary subwoofer, isn't meant to use with music. I tried, we made this experiment just to show you that you can follow the rhythm of the music, but it's impossible to stay with the rhythm of the music because it's a mass problem. Let me explain you better. So the real subwoofer is made with a paper cone, and it's made in paper not because it's cheap, but because the paper is very lightweight, so it can move very, very fast because it's very, very light. So you can imagine this is just like, this is paper, so it's very lightweight. So if I take the paper, I can shake it very rapidly with no problems. It's very, very lightweight. If you take something much heavier, for example, all the components of this project, so we have stainless steel, we have aluminium, we have plastic components, even if I choose like very, very lightweight materials, are much heavier than paper. So you can make an experiment together and you can see that paper can move rapidly and this kilogram of aluminium can't because it has much more mass and I can't really follow the same frequency. So the mass is a problem. So we cannot use it with music, but it's great for creating sound effects. For example, at a theater or in a cinema, you can really create them, follow like the explosion sounds, or maybe there's a car crash or a bomb. You can recreate and program this rotary subwoofer to turn on only when there is this effect, and all the people inside the cinema will feel it, not mainly by the ears, but they will say, whoa, what's happening? Because you feel this change of pressure in the room, and that's crazy. Talking about rooms, it's so important to create a hole and have this fan between the two rooms. Or the most important thing, the best part is to have it in front of a window with an open space. So you can really have maximum efficiency. So you have a closed room and the out space, and you move the air from in and out, and this create this very, very high pressure inside the room. That's the main reason. It's crucial to have a round hole. That's the reason why. If you place, for example, the fan in the middle of the room, even if it's going with the rhythm music, it's just like an air blower. So you just sit in front and have fresh air in front of your face, but no effect, no subwoofer effect is created by this. So important to have a hole. So remember that this is a YouTube channel that talks about only tutorials. I share with you my passion, the experiments and the things, just to give you inspiration. So I'm not here to tell you this is the right way to do it. It's just, yeah, this is the idea. You can do it better. You can for sure improve the solenoid right here that is making so much sound. This is a very, very, I don't like it, but I don't know what I can use instead. So if you know what I can use instead this solenoid, yeah, that's a great idea. Just leave a comment below. And yeah, I leave you right here now my two previous projects. Check them out. The last one was a little stove powered by aluminium foil. It was so interesting. Check it out and see you next week. Ciao, ciao.